Tensions have boiled over in the Bachelorette mansion. Last night, Charlie revealed to Ali how Nathan was chatting to the boys about the rumours between her and Grant. Of course, that's Grant, the man from Bachelor in Paradise, who broke her heart. Ali took the information very seriously and confronted Nathan about it at the cocktail party.
Gave me the boot.
Nathan!
Yes?
Hi!
Hi!
I heard you were saying really disgusting things about me this afternoon. And I want to know what it is that you were saying.
Holy crap, I can... OK.
If you can't tell me honestly what's happened, then I don't think we can move on.
What you did say was quite... I didn't like it. I know Charlie didn't like it.
I said what I had heard, but that was not the first thing that was said.
I doubt that. Why would any of us bring that up?
You can see it in her eyes. Ellie is generally hurt by this.
I have to analyse everyone because I've been so hurt in the past because I've had people, like, just delivering lines to me.
Yeah.
I've had people saying, yeah, I want two kids too. Yeah, I want to get married too. But then when I go visit them in LA, they're a party animal and that they don't actually want to settle down and have kids and have a marriage. It's time for you to go. If you're not here for me, you're gone.
Well, Nathan was sent home before the rose ceremony and he joins us this morning on Studio 10. Nathan, good morning.
Thanks, guys.
So, that was a lot of tension there. Why did you feel that you needed to bring up these rumours about Ali's past?
Look, it wasn't so much that I just felt the need to, but, you know, we were all just sitting around the pool talking about, you know, what we'd heard and... you know, it was an off-camera conversation that we had purely because of that reason. It's not really a public discussion. It doesn't need to be like that. And the fact that it was actually brought up on camera is—it's kind of, you know, it drags Ali's name through the dirt, kind of.
But are you not mindful though that there's cameras in the house 24/7, and you understand that what is always on mic or what you say will be filmed?
Well, we're actually not always on camera, and we're not always on mic. When we're in the pool, we're sitting around the pool on the weekend. The crew's not there all of the time.
Yeah, because it was Charlie that actually told Ali about what you'd said by the pool, so it wasn't filmed or recorded, was it? But
no.
Do you regret now? Having had that conversation?
No, not at all. I mean, look, realistically, I feel like we are all entitled to have that chat because we're all meant to be falling in love with this girl. You know, whether it's, you know, it doesn't taint my, you know, decision. I don't think she's any less of a person. We've all got a pass, and I'm the first person to say that we all make mistakes.
So it was a discussion about something that happened in... Ali's past?
Yeah, it was.
Yeah.
And that's the thing, like, it was in the past. It's not like it changed my, you know, decision. It's not like I wanted to, oh, no, I cannot be with this girl now. It's just, we just talked about it and just go, OK, that's what we've heard and that's it. It was just a lighthearted conversation.
But how did you feel that moment we saw then when Ali's confronted you, you said this about, how were you feeling at that moment?
It was pretty funny because, like, I mean, I was just come off the back of this really nice conversation where she just said, I really like you, I want to get to know you more, and then... I turn around, I hear a voice again, so I was like, oh, a little bit happy, turn around, and I could see it written on her face that this wasn't going to be the same conversation. This was going to be something a lot more intense.
What, did you have feelings for Ali? Do you think you developed feelings for her?
Like, at that point in time, like, I know I didn't really have that much time with her. You know, I was kind of starting to think that maybe we were developing a connection. I think you could see that through the little chat we had just before I left. But it was sad to leave at that point in time. But, yeah, no, it was... At the same time, I was like, OK, well, this is just my time.
And we can sort of blame Charlie for this, can't we? Because it was Charlie who told Ali about what you'd said. So how do you feel about him, what he did?
Oh, look, Charlie acts the exact way that he felt like it was necessary in that scenario. The only thing is that, like, I would never do that to somebody else. I don't think that's my place to do it. But that's the thing. We've just got different morals and different motives for things, so...
Did he break the bro code?
He definitely broke the bro code. In saying that, this season, there was no bro code. It was all pulling hair and claws.
Really?
Yeah. There was no bro code.
Did you find it was quite tense and everyone was out there for themselves? Do you think the dynamics
100%.
Have changed?
This year they obviously cast, they felt the need to cast for, like, alpha males. I think it was just a lot of big personalities clashing.
And what about since? Have you found love?
I haven't found love, no, not yet. It's still coming, I think.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. Now, in Bachelor in Paradise is coming back. Are you going to sign up for that, do you think?
We'll see. See if they want me on there. If they do, I don't know. It'd be pretty cool to, you know, head overseas and have, you know, have a chat with a few girls from other shows, but
and
we'll
keep
see
the bro code.
You That's must it. Find it pretty exciting chatting to us couple of girls now.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I can see your eyes look quite alight.
Yeah, that's what it is. It's, yeah. For sure.
I think he's actually frightened. He's like, get me off here. Now, of course, don't miss the next episode of The Bachelorette next Wednesday at 7:30 p.m. on 10 and Win. Nathan, we've loved watching you and thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks, guys.